question will be, the first thing is return type. The general form will be return type function name, return type function name, argument list or list of parameter, then open the parenthesis, close the parenthesis, body of the function. So this is a general syntax. So whatever function you look, this will be the general syntax. Return type, so this is a return type, so this can be the basic data types, or this can be anything, can be struct also. So usually this will be integer, float, double, character, then even the functions can return struct also. So it can, or it can return object also. So the return type, so first one is the return type. So what return type will do means it will specify the value to be returned. So from this function, what is the value to be returned? So the function can return any value. The function can return any value except array. And if you don't want the function to return any value, you will give the return type as void. So this is regarding the return type. So what return type will do means it will, one second, I think some people are waiting in lobby, I think. Okay. So return type. So this is general format is return type function name within the parenthesis argument list, like within the brackets argument list, then open the parenthesis, close the parenthesis, within the parenthesis body of the function. So what return type will do means it will tell the value to be returned from the function. So it can return any value except array. If it is not returning any value means you can use the function, you can use the return type as void. The next thing is parameter list. So the next thing is parameter list, or we will call it as the argument list. So what this argument list will do means, so it will tell how many arguments are there for this function called function name. So here the arguments are separated by comma, for example, integer a comma integer b comma integer c. See here, this parameter is separated from this parameter through the comma operator. B and C are separated through comma operator. So here the variables, so it will tell how many arguments are there, and each arguments are separated by comma. So after this the body of the function, see, this body of the function is where the actual logic will be returned, actual code will be written. So for example, if you are trying to find out the square root of a number, so the logic for that will be written here. If you are trying to find the cube of a number, the logic for that will be written inside the body of a function. Or if you want to check whether a number is prime or not, so the logic will be written inside the body of the function. So this is regarding the general format of the function. So after this, what components are there in the function? See, the first thing is, like in the last class I told you, function will have function declaration. A function will have function declaration, or you can call it as prototype. A function will have function declaration or prototype. Then the functions can contain parameters. The parameters means the arguments. The parameters are arguments. After that, function definition, where the actual logic will be written. So, and also function call. So these are some of the components, and also return type. So these are the components of the function. So this function can, function will have function declaration. Function declaration means, I'll tell it in detail. You can call it as function declaration or function prototype. It will have arguments. See here, I've written arguments. It will have function definition, means the body or the logic. So here it is done. After that, function calling and return type. So these are the components of the function. So now, what is this function prototype? So we'll go one by one. So what is this function prototype? What is the usage of this function prototype? See, function prototype means the function prototype. I'll just explain with an example. For example, integer add integer. So last class I was talking about this as function declaration. It will be written after the preprocessor files. So this is function prototype. So it will contain the return type, function name, the list of arguments ended with semicolon. So this is function declaration. So like this is the way you will identify the function declaration. But we'll talk about what is function declaration or what is function prototype. See, it will give some informations to the compiler. See, this function prototype or function declaration will give some information to the compiler. So what are those information means? One thing is, what is the name of this function? What is the name of this function? What is the return type of this function? And how many arguments are there? And what are their types? So these informations will be given to the compiler by this function prototype. So what it is giving? It is giving you the name of the function, the return type of the function. I mean the return type, whether it is returning integer data type or float data type, like that. After that, the number of arguments or the number of parameters and the type of arguments. So all these things information will be given by the function prototype. So why it is done means whenever you call the function, the compiler will check the function call with its prototype. So if I'm trying to call one statement inside the main function as add of 5, 10, so this is function call. So whenever I write like this, so the compiler will check the function call with its prototype so that correct number of arguments, two arguments are used, and also the correct data type. Here also we're using integer data type and integer data type. So this is the importance. of function prototype. What function prototype is doing means, it will tell the compiler, here we are using an add function. It is returning an integer data type and it contains two arguments, and two arguments are of type. What is the type? Integer data type. One thing is, you need not specify the name of the parameter. See, here I'm not giving some names like A, B, C. That is optional. You need not specify the name. You just need to define the data type. So what is the data type of the argument? What is the data type of the parameter? So what is function prototype means? It will tell the compiler about the name of the function, return type of the function, how many arguments are there, and what are their types. And also giving names to this parameters is optional. What is the importance of this prototype? So one thing is like, one second, I'll check if anyone is there in lobby or not. Okay. So what is the importance of this function prototype is the return value. So the return value will be handled correctly. So this return value will be handled correctly. If you are using function prototype, the return value of the function will be handled correctly. And also, I told you that correct type and correct number of arguments will be passed. So that means, if I go with the example, if the function contains two arguments will be passed, and if they are of integer data type, the integer data type will be passed. So these are the importance of this function prototype. One thing is, return value of the function will be handled correctly, correct type and correct number of arguments will be passed to the functions. So now what will happen if the function prototype is not there? So if the function prototype is not there, means the compiler will assume the type, like the if I'm not writing a function prototype, if I'm not writing this function prototype means the compiler, here I know that for this function called add, the return type should be integer. So if I forget to write this statement, if I forget to write this line, then what will happen means the compiler will assume the return type. For example, for our function, if you are expecting the return type as integer, the compiler might assume float, or the compiler might assume double, or the compiler might assume character. See, that is what. So if you forget to write the statement in the absence of prototype, the compiler will assume the return type value. So sometimes it may return an incompatible type. So for example, I'm expecting the integer return type, but the compiler might return an float return type. So in that case, what will happen means the compiler will show the error on the function definition part. It will not show the error on the function calling part. What it will tell, that the function calling is correct, you just check the function definition. So if it is absent, means the error will be put up on the function definition. They won't consider the function call. The compiler will treat that the function call is correct, but the function definition is wrong. But it is the other way around. So that is what. So well, this is one scenario. If the function definition is in file one, assume that this is file one, and if the function definition is in this file, you're compiling from other file, so that is like the function definition is in one file, then you're calling this function from another file, then in that case the compile time error will not come, but you will get the wrong result. so that is the second thing. So because here the error will be decided against the function definition. I told you that even though there is a wrong call from the function call, but they will blame it on the function definition. And one more thing is, if the function definition is in another file and the function calling is in another file, and in that scenario, it will give the wrong result, but errors, it will not give you the error. These are the disadvantages. So that's why the function prototype is needed. So once you give the function prototype, it will give an error on the function call, not on the function definition. So that is why this function prototype is needed. And also this function prototype will promote the type conversion, the automatic type conversion, whenever appropriate. So these are some of the reasons why you need function prototype. So any doubts here? Any doubts with respect to function prototype? The first part, any doubts with respect to function prototype? Yes or no?
No, sir.
Okay. So this is regarding the function prototype. We will talk about few more components of the function, and after that we can go with examples. So this is function prototype is done. So after that, function definition. So function definition, see, function prototype I'll write here. I'll just write the function prototype. The first line is, this is function prototype. You just one example. This is function prototype. So now function definition. So function definition it is the one which contains the body of the function. The syntax will remain same, integer add. Then here you can give the names of the variables, integer a comma integer b. So this will contain the body of the function. This will contain the body of the function. So here I can write the logic, integer c is equal to a plus b, then return c. So this is an example of function definition. So what this function definition means, this the first line of the function definition will be same as the function declaration. You can check that. So the this line is same as this line, except that here you are not using semicolon and you are adding the parameters and body of the function is there. So the declaration is same. So here also you know that it will use the same function name, same number of parameters and same return type. The only thing is you're writing logic. For example, this is an add function to add two numbers. So what I'm writing inside the body of the function, I'm just performing the addition of two numbers, that is a and b, and I'm sending the result, and I'm sending the result back to the caller. So this is the usage of function definition. So function definition is the place where the logic will be written. So for example, inside the main function, you might write a logic to perform the addition, the simple arithmetic operation. Simple arithmetic operation means add will be there, subtract will be there, multiplication will be there, then division will be there. So this program is used to perform simple arithmetic operations. So outside somewhere in the function, you will write a function definition called add. What it will do? It will perform addition. You'll write one module called subtract. It will perform logic to perform subtraction. One function definition called multiplication. It will write the logic for multiplication, the same for division also. So the simple arithmetic program is being divided into four modules. One module for performing addition, one module for performing subtraction, one module for performing multiplication, and one module for performing division. So you are breaking a main program into sub parts. So wherever you check the logic, you are writing inside the function definition. So this is function definition. So this function definition will contain only the logic to perform specific action. So after that, function calling. So function call, how to call this function? Some function name called some values. I will give it as 10, 20. So I have to store the results, so I'll declare it as integer result is equal to, because this function will return the result integer value. So I need some variable called result to store that value. So what it will tell means this function will call the function called it will invoke the function called add which contains two integers. Then here a will get the value, here a will get the value 10, b will get the value 20. So then the addition will be performed, 10 plus 20. So C contains 30. So C contains 30. So that 30 will be returned. So that 30, the result of this add function is 30. So that 30 will be stored in result variable. So what it will do means it will call the function definition, or it will invoke the function definition. It will pass two integer parameters. The control will be transferred to the first statement of the function, like function body, where the addition will be performed, that is integer c is equal to a plus b. After that, the control will go to the next line, return c. So once the control is returned, once the statement return c is executed, the control will come to this function calling integer result is equal to add of 10 comma 20. So here what it is doing means it is just calling that function definition. Once the result is being done, that result is being stored here. So this is regarding the function calling. So these are the three parameters: function definition, function declaration, function definition, function calling. So in addition to this, 4 and 5 are like argument list. One is like argument list or argument types. So argument list means it will specify how many number of arguments are there, what are their types. So, and also in argument, see here also, you can use various number of arguments. Like it's not time free for your understanding. I'll just explain with the integer data types. So you can use float also, you can use a double also. So that is left to you. So based on the type of operation which you're using, you can specify. And the last one is return type. So what return type will do means it will give you what the function is returning. So that is the example of return type. So any doubt here? Any doubt with respect to the function prototype? Function prototype?
No, sir.
Okay. So then shall we start with the programmings related to this function? Some two programs are there, simple one. So we'll just execute that. So after that, we can proceed with further examples. I think that will be better. So we'll start with that only then, because easy. Like theory part, now you know the theory. So if you just execute the practicals, I think you will get a good grip. You will get a good grip on this subject. So I think we can start with the examples. We can start with the examples. So after this, we have function overloading also. We have already discussed about the function overloading. The same thing. We can revise it once again also, so that this function part will be clear. So now I'll just go with the examples. See, I'll just go with one addition example. One example which will cover all the concepts. So let us go with addition thing only. Arithmetic operations. So first line will be function declaration. So function declaration can be done into four types. Okay. Function declaration. So what is the first thing? The first name should be return type. Return type, function name, parameters. So this is a function declaration for add function. So so some variation. See, there are four types, there are four categories: with return type, without return type, like parameters with return type, without return type, no parameters with return type, without return, like four categories of functions are. You would have studied in C the same thing. See here, this add is an example. This add function declaration is an example of with return type and parameters. So like this, I'll write four things. So I don't want return type, so I'll give it as void, subtract, but I want parameters, integer. So this is a function declaration of without return type and with parameters. See, there are four categories of functions. One is some functions will take parameters and it will return the return type. Some functions won't take parameters, but it will return the return types. And some functions will not take parameters and it will not return any return type also. And some functions will take parameter, but it will not return type. So I'll just write it here. See, functions can be categorized into four parts. Okay. One is some functions, it will take parameters in that also two categories: parameters with return type, parameters without return type, one category. some functions will take return type. Here also it will take return type, but without parameter, with parameter. So with parameter, with return type, one kind. With parameter, without return type, the second one. With return type, without parameter, the third one. And with return type, with parameter, fourth one. So four examples are there. So see here, I'm writing this one is with parameter, with return type. The second one, parameter is there, return type is not there. For next two, it won't take any parameters. But it will give return type. With return type, no parameters. No return type, no parameters. So four categories. So there are four ways of declaring the functions. These are the four varieties of function declaration of function categories. Any doubt here? Any doubt? See, they're categorizing, that's all. Some combinations. So this is like with return type and no parameters. No parameters. This is the last one. No return type and parameters. Any doubt here? See, these are the four categories. Already would have studied in C, but I'm just revising that. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
This is regarding the function. This is regarding the function declaration. So next thing is function definition. So function definition, first I'll write add. So add function takes integer, the same, it should be same. The function definition should be same as function declaration. Add can contain variable name, so I'll write it as a comma b. So after that I'll just write integer c is equal to a plus b. Integer c is equal to a plus b. I want to pass the value return c. Whenever return type is there, the last line should be return. So this is the logic for addition. So the same way. So what is the logic should I write for subtraction? So the for subtraction, void sub integer, I can give it as I'll give it as x comma integer y. Then the body of the function. See, one difference between function declaration and function body is here semicolon should be removed and it should be replaced with the parenthesis. So it has to perform the subtraction. Z is equal to the first number minus second number, x minus y. Then it doesn't return any parameter, it doesn't return any function. So I'll just print the value of z. Subtraction result is, there's result is stored in variable z. So result is stored in variable z. Inline. So this is the logic for subtraction. So after that, what is the logic for division? What is the logic for multiplication? So multiplication, it contains return type. Multiplication contains return type, but it is not containing any variable. So multiplication is not having any variable. So for you can write the variables here. Integer m with 50, integer n with 20. See, I'm writing the variables here. If you're not, you can also read it from the keyboard also. Instead of integer m is equal to 50, integer m is equal to 20, you can write this line also, m, n. So here I'm just hard coding the value. Here if you write like this, you can read it from the keyboard itself. You can write like this also. Integer m is equal to 20, n is equal to integer p is equal to m star n. So I have to return the value. So return p. So this is regarding the multiplication function and division function. it will not take any parameter and it will not return any value. Here also I'll write integer jkllj is equal to 100, integer k is equal to 20. Then division means l is equal to j slash k. So result c out, because I'm not passing value, division result is, then it should be stored in l. Two more corrections are there, I'll just do that. Slash in. Okay. Now I've written the function to perform division logic. This will do multiplication, this will do subtraction, and this will do addition. So all this I have to call it from the main function. So inside the main function, I will call it as addition. No, for addition, it is returning some integer variable. So integer d is equal to addition of, let me add 50, 75. So I will print the result. It is stored in d. C out, addition result is stored in d. After this, subtraction doesn't store anything, so I'll just call subtraction of 50, 20, because it is not returning any type, whereas multiplication is returning a type. So integer some variable r is equal to multiplication, so it is not taking any parameter. The parameters we have written there, we'll just need to store the result. C out, multiplication result is r, so slash n. After that, I want to call the division. For division, I just need to call that function, no need to pass the variables. So see, you check here itself in the main function, I'm calling four different functions. I'm calling the add function, I'm calling the subtract function, multiplication function, division function. So build, so l is equal to, so data type I have not declared, so integer l is equal to j by k. So build, so no error. So if I run this, see the output. I'll just format that, just give a space, that's all. Division result is, somewhere the space issue will be there, nothing else. Subtraction result is, then multiplication result is space thing. Okay, so I will build this, I'll run this. See, addition result is 20, is 125, because 50 plus 75 is 125. Subtraction result is 30. Why? Because 50, 20, 50 minus 20. Then multiplication result is 1000, because I'm giving two values, 50, 20. So 50 into 20 will be 1000. And division result is 5, because 100, 20. So you can check that the results are there. So we'll, the results are there. Here I've given the values. Here I've just hard coded the values. If you want, you can add complex. You can add this. You can also modify this functions in such a way that you will be reading the values from the keyboard. You can take this as an homework. So the same function, you try to add values from the keyboard. So for that, I'll just give one example. So I want to call this add function. No, I'll just write it as integer a comma b. So after that, I'll just write one statement. Enter a and b value. Enter a and b value. So enter a and b value. After that, c in of a b. Read the values of a and b. So here you have to pass. So for add function, I will show. For the remaining functions, you try to implement that. So now see the same program. I'll build this. I'll run this. See, I'm giving the values of a. values of A, I'll give it as 500. B, I'll give it as 1000. The output, I'll get it as 1500. The result of addition result is 1500, subtraction result, and all remain same, because there I'm not reading the values from the keyboard. I'm just assigning the value directly. The same way you can also do that, but you try implementing this, you try giving the values from the keyboard. Any doubt in this program? Any doubt with respect to this function prototype program? Any doubt? See, everything is covered. Everything, whatever is needed from the function concept, it is being covered here. Any doubt? If you're not understanding anything, you just let me know so that you'll be clear with this concept. Any doubt here? Yes or no? Kushi?
No, sir.
Megan?
No, sir.
So is this part understood? Or any more explanation
is needed? Yes,
sir. Okay. So if this part is done, so we'll just modify this. I'll just modify this. I'll remove other functions. We'll just concentrate on addition function for remaining of our concepts. Modify this accordingly. So wherever it is needed, as per our concept, we'll modify this accordingly. See, here you can check in the function declaration. Once again, I'll just take a screenshot of this. See here. I've written function declaration. No, so here I can give the default values. So for this function declaration, I can give the default values. Like, I can give default values for some arguments. See, for example, I can give default values for this argument. Or I can give the default value for the entire concept. For example, for these two integers, I can give the default value for the right side parameter. Or if I feel like I want to give the default values for all the parameters, I can do that also. So in this C++, you can specify the default values for some parameters, or you can specify default values for all the parameters in a function. So why and when this default value will be used? The first point is, you can specify the default values for this function definitions. You can specify the default values for this function definitions. So either you can specify the default values for only few variables or all the variables. That is the next thing. That is few arguments or all the arguments. So when this default values will be used? The first thing is, you can assign the default values. You can assign to few arguments or all the arguments. And when this default value will be used. So in function calling, if you're not using any variables, if you're not passing any value, at that time, the default value will be used. So during the function call, if you are not passing any value, then the default value will be used. So if you are passing the values, then default value will not be used. For example, see, is the definitions clear? Is this concept clear, default value? See, one thing is, you can give default values to the arguments in function declaration. You can give default value to few arguments or to all the arguments also. So these default values will be used whenever you are not using any values in the function call. So whenever you are not using any values in the function call, then default value will be used. But if you are using the values in the function call, then it will be used. Then the default value will not be used at all. And one more thing is, default values has to be assigned from right hand side, it has to be assigned from right hand side to the left hand side. It has to be assigned from right hand side to the left hand side. So here, first you have to start, if there are three values, if there are three variables, integer A, integer B, integer C. So first you have to give default value to C. C will, first thing you have to give to C, then to B, and then to C. So that is how the default value should be assigned. But because you cannot give default value to B, and if you try to miss, it will throw an error. So that is the one thing you should keep in mind. The default values has to be assigned from right hand side to the left hand side. Otherwise, if you're not giving the default value for the right hand side variable, and if you're trying to specify the default value for the left hand side variable, the compiler will throw an error. So let's check this with an example. So the first one we'll start with this. So we'll perform the addition of three numbers this time. We'll perform the addition of three numbers. Okay, so values, I will not read it from the keyboard. We'll just pass the values only, so that it will be easy for you people to remember. So integer, I'll call this as result of addition, A comma B comma C. Then here also integer A comma B comma C is there, no? Integer A comma B comma C. Here I'll take it as D is equal to A plus B plus C, return D. Some modification I made modification for this program. So now now we'll start with I'll just type the result. C out. Result of addition is, it will be stored in result variable. So I told you that you can give default values. So first time I'll give, just give 10 comma 20 comma 30. So I will build this. So what will be the output of this function? See, if I run this program, what output I will get? Can anyone answer? So if you are able to answer, means it is understood that you are following the classes. Can anyone answer what will be the output of this program? Addition of 10 comma 20 comma 30. What will be the output? So unmute and answer. See, what will be the output of this function? Kushi, what will be the output of this function? See, someone has to answer. Yes, someone told the right answer. Who told 60? See, the answer for this will be 60. See, it will perform the addition of three numbers, 10, 20, 30. So if I run this, I'll get the output as 60. So now I will start giving default values. Now I'll start giving some default values. So instead of 30, the default value will be 50. So instead of 30, the default value will be 50. So in that case, what will happen? I'll build this. And I'm giving the default value is 50. Just one second, I'll explain this. See, what I did means, now I told you that you can give default values to all the parameters. or only one parameter, but it should start from the right hand side. So now for the right side parameter, I given the default value as 50. Okay. So now I've given the default value as 50, and I'm calling this function add function with only two parameters. I'm calling this function add with only two parameters, and the third parameter value is missing. The third parameter value is missing. So since it is missing, the default value 50 will be taken care. So now if I run this program, the output will be 10 plus 20 is 30, 30 plus 50 will be 80. See, I'm getting the output as 80 because I'm not using the third parameter. The default value will be considered. No, sir, I don't want to give default value. So I will give 30 means. So in this case, it will be executed normally. The default value will not be considered. Whatever value you are passing, that will be considered. So build, run, see, result of addition is 60. Okay. But if I don't use this variable, I'll get the output as 80 because C value is missing. So it will take the default value. Similarly, I'll give the default value of second parameter as 150. Okay, 150. So now if I write 10 comma 20, so now what will happen? If I write 10 comma 20, the default value for C will be taken and output will get it as 80. So I'll now take this also. Now result of 10. So now since it doesn't contain any value of B and C, the default value of B is 50 and the default value of third parameter is 50 and the default value of second parameter is 150. These two will be taken. So the addition will be 10 plus 150 plus 50. So the output will be 210. See, the output is 210. You're understanding this? Yes or no? You're following this? See, whenever the value is missing, it will take the default values. Even I can give the default value, of 200. So now I'll call this function with no parameter, with no values only. This add function is not taking any value. So it will take the default value. See, it is getting the output as 400. So I told you that the assignment has to be from the right hand side. So what will happen if I take it from the left hand side? So left hand side, and I'll give the value as 10. Now I will get an error because see, the compiler doesn't know whether it has to assign this value 10. See, it is taking this value 10 as the first value. So you can check that it is taking the value 10 as the value for the first argument integer A, highlighted one. So in that case, but the value C doesn't have any defaulting. So that's why you will get an error. So that's why the assignment should be always from the right hand side to the left hand side, not the other way around. So these are some of the concepts that are related to the default function. So it is always possible for you to assign from right hand side to the left hand side. If you are trying to assign from left hand side to the right hand side, the compiler will throw an error because in our example the third value is missing. And also see that the default value should always be mentioned. The default value should always be mentioned in the function definition. So if you are trying to write the default values in the function definition, so the default values should always be mentioned in the function prototype or function declaration. If you are trying to give the default values in the function definition, the compiler will not know that. So remember, in the function prototype, I have to give the default values because the function definitions will be usually in the other files. So that is the one thing. So always specify the default values in the function prototype or function declaration. Don't specify that in function definition. And also I told you that the function the default value should be assigned from the right hand side to the left hand side. That is the next thing. And also one thing is, like, if you are using function overloading, I'll just explain this. I'll just explain this in the next class. So if you're using function overloading, for example, like here there is one function. So I'm using the function overloading concept, integer add of integer comma integer. So now there will be chance of error. Now there will be a chance of error. With the example, I'll explain the next class. So during the function overloading also, the chances of getting error is more. I will tell that with a suitable programming example. So as of now, any doubts with respect to this default values in function prototype? Any doubts?
No, sir.